Hi, my name is Ulrich Dirnagl. I'm a translational stroke researcher from Berlin. I direct a stroke research center there. And I think the next big thing in stroke will be to look more at complications. Why? First of all, of course, we have thrombolysis, which is nice and very effective, but it only is only very few patients in the end will be eligible for it. Neuroprotection still is elusive. And complications are highly frequent, they are prevalent, they are important for the outcome of patients, and we know not so much about them. Of course, we have some ideas why patients get complications, but I think we have been missing out on a lot of the basic biology behind it. And I'll have just three examples for it. One, for example, is the immune system. We know that stroke depresses the immune system. We know that this is relevant for infections. Infections are a major complication. For example, pneumonia is the number one cause of death in stroke. And we certainly could place more emphasis in this and probably prevent some of those complications by, for example, earlier treatment or even blocking immunodepression. One other area could be, for example, the effects of stroke on metabolism. We know that stroke patients develop cachexia, wasting. We know little about the mechanisms. Of course, they are not moving as they should do, but there is also biochemistry behind it. Stroke appears to induce some kind of a wasting process in the muscles, and there are ways of blocking this, at least in animal experiments. And more experimentally or maybe wildly, there could be a link between the gut and the brain in stroke. There are many reasons to believe that this could be relevant for the outcome of stroke patients, although I have to admit that this is only experimental data that we have so far. So in taking together, I think we have been neglecting complications in stroke, at least at the basic research level. And I would predict that there are highly relevant therapeutic targets hidden in all this, and many of them will have a very favorable temporal window also, because we might be able to treat them even after hours after the stroke has occurred. That's what I think.